Here we go again, back with more pro cycling mania. This race is yet to done before. It was the first World Tour race, if I remember correctly. We ended up 24th, which was a really good result, much better than expected. I'm of course talking about Amstel Gold Race or Master Kvalenburg, as its official name is. But I'm trying for top 20 this time. Hopefully I can improve a couple of places, and because this result last year was actually pretty surprisingly good, so if I can sit up front and relax a lot, maybe I'll get a good result here as well. I am of course a year better, so I should be able to improve a couple of places in the overall standings. Okay, the finale has started now. They are attacking. I have no water, which is really bad timing. This is the steepest hill of the entire day. Bit stuck behind La Sudale help, I think. Oh, it's actually Tim Willens, who's a pretty strong rider. But I don't know if he's strong enough today. I can't keep up with the front rider, so I'll just have to ride my own pace, I think, up this hill. Oh, if I could have made it in this group up here, that'd be so good. But I just don't think I'm strong enough for that. I'll try and attack anyway. Just because I can. Get some water. As well. Don't know how many riders are in front of me. It's 17 riders. So I have to beat quite a few of these riders to actually get a good place overall. And Matthews is a really strong rider for Navamart as well. Water Pools, Tarame. Don't even really care about catching the riders in front of me, but there are 30 riders behind me right here who are catching up with us really fast right now. Geschke, Stuber, for example, Galopang, Jan Bakerlands. The group is right up there, but I can't catch them. Michael Matthews is bridging the gap to them. It's too good to be sitting down here as well, so probably fair enough. Maybe I shouldn't have tried to follow them on the first attack. I should have probably just have ridden my own pace. I tried to get in the breakaway earlier because I remembered last year the reason why I got such a good place was because they caught me while I was in the breakaway and I was able to hang on with them for quite a while. This time, on the other hand, I wasn't allowed in the breakaway. I tried multiple times, which is probably why I have lost as much energy as I have. But I'm not strong enough to even get top 30. I don't think so, at least. I'm already completely out of my yellow bar. I'll just take my gel now, because I might as well use it to sit up here for as long as possible. Still a bit of prick group up in front. We still haven't reached Kauberg yet. There goes my top 30 place, I think. Just slowly riding my own pace home now. They have only have 1 kilometer, 400 meters to the finish line in the front. I'm thinking Alaphilippe actually wins by quite a bit, over a minute seems, before the rest of the... Wow, he absolutely demolished them. I think he got in the breakaway by himself. Dondo actually got in second, that's surprising to me. Kwiatkowski, Willens, Kelderman, Gilbert, Daniel Martin, Valverde and Mollema. Is this the rest, or is this just a group that was in before who broke apart in two? But yeah, there's not really much to drive for anymore. Up off Kauberg here. And yeah, I think I got like in the bottom of this group, which is probably like top 50. Top 50 is okay, considering I was not even the captain on the team, was almost on the bottom of the list. So it's an okay result. I was kind of hoping for, as I said, top 20. But to do that, I had to get in front of the favorites at some point of the race and then relax and let them catch me instead. Which didn't happen, since they considered me such a big threat that I just couldn't get away at any point. So this is an okay result as well. I was hoping for a bit better, But I'm going to ride the Fresh of Alon right now, and hopefully we can get a good result there, because that's the first time I'm riding that race, I would think, if I remember correctly. Okay, here we have the La Flèche Wallonne, and actually not that hard of a race, but the final climb in real life as well, at least, is really, really steep, and also pretty long, muddy hui, of course, but it never really shows up that much in the game itself, because the game considers, if it's 2 kilometers long, you can just sprint all the way up, and it's just the best sprinter of the climbers to win. So guys like Witkowski, Michael Matthews, are probably Valverde as well, will probably be some of the favorites, guys with high acceleration and high hill stats. I don't have neither, so to get a chance, I have to go in a breakaway earlier and make this race as tough as possible. I don't think I'll be allowed to go in a breakaway, but that's a whole other story. Let's just get the race started. It's the first time I'm racing this, so I have no idea how it's going to be ridden. Okay, so I just tried to attack on this little climb a minute ago here, and I got countered by Kwiatkowski and Alaphilippe and Valverde and Gilbert and all kinds of great riders. I'm wondering, I'm just a lonely 75 hill stats guy. Why are they trying to go after me? I just tried to get away to get a little gap to them, but I'm not allowed to get away in any way or form, apparently. I'm no threat overall, honestly. Duarte is the captain of a team. He's looking pretty good at +4 day shape. And more water than me, more yellow bar than me, more green bar than me right now. So I don't really know why they're caring that much about a lowly rider like me. I'm just going for a good top 10, top 20 placement. I'm not even going to gain any XP from this, since I've already got like top 5 in Tour Down Under. So I don't think I'll get anything from this. Anyway, have we even got to the steep section yet? You see the final climb and this climb come up here are both really steep. I'm thinking about attacking here as well. If I have to attack, it should be now, because the climb begins here, so I have to get up to speed now. 8% right here, should be up to like 15-20% right now. 17-18% right here. Is that Alaphilippe, of course, riding for Katusha right now, attacking behind me. Let's see, I think I actually got away in a little group here. Can I get some water quickly before everybody comes up behind me? Oh, I got water. But I got away with Daniel Martin and Alaphilippe won Amstel Gold Race, of course. But the person is right here, mind you, Kwiatkowski. Valverde, Simon Gerrans, here now, Gilbert, all of the favorites are sitting right here. Surprised that the peloton didn't really break into more pieces than that, so seems like my break was pretty useless. At least I got some water, which was really nice for me. It seems to have broken apart, actually. I am in the front group now, Duarte is not there, so I'm the only one up front. Of course, Bichon's still in the breakaway group, but that's soon to be caught, I think. So I have got some water now. 40 riders sitting up in the front group right now. Not 100 riders sitting behind. But they're probably not the favorites sitting in that group. I wouldn't imagine so, at least. So we have this not so steep climb coming up. Then we have the climb just before the finish, which is, I think, actually a new climb. I don't remember if it was this year or last year that it was inserted into the route to make the finish a bit more exciting, because usually it was almost the entire peloton going into the Mur de Huy. This year instead, it has been a bit more exciting. I'm losing a lot of energy just sitting right here, but the pace that Kwiatkowski is setting right now is so high that I don't have any chance of following right now. I'm nowhere near strong enough to keep up here. The only thing I'm doing right now is pretty much just blocking the guys behind me, because I will be dropped. Maybe already on this little small climb, but hopefully I can hang on until the second to last climb. Right now I'm in top 20, but I think there's some strong riders behind me who will without a doubt overtake me. I'm completely plugging in Daniel Moreno right now, which is pretty sad for him, but I don't really care. It's guys like Galopang, Barkerlands down here, Sepulveda, Fandata as well, for example. Contador is actually one of the top favorites, but he's sitting in a completely wrong place. So I'm completely out of energy right now. I might as well just use my energy gel, since I really have no other use for it. As we head up the second to last climb right now, 17 man group up front. I'm predicting Kwiatkowski has probably attacked, and maybe he's just leading the peloton. I can't really see what's going up front. It's just Kwiatkowski leading. Daniel Martin attacks. Kwiatkowski go after him. Alaphilippe, Mollema as well. Will Daniel Martin? It seems like these three riders up here, Daniel Martin, Kwiatkowski, and Alaphilippe, are the strongest and will probably decide the states between them. Duarte has caught up with me. I have no energy left, of course, so I'm not really afraid, and we still have the Motori to go. Looking good for top 50 again, it seems. And now in Valverde attacking. I'm not looking that great right now. I can't really see what's going up ahead because of the trees and the camera changing all the time. But we have the three riders up here. Gilbert has joined them as well. I think Kwiatkowski just dropped. I think it's going to be Daniel Martin or Gilbert winning this one. Daniel Martin does win it in front of Gilbert. Kwiatkowski, Alaphilippe, Willens and Valverde. I'm just going all out. Maybe I can. Maybe there's some other riders here who I can overtake on the last bit. Duarte just is the strongest guy in this group, but I do beat Sani and De Klerk for not ending last in this group, which is pretty alright to me. Next up is the Lisbon Liège, but I'm going to do that video by itself because it is a monument, so I feel like it deserves its own video, even though it won't be that long, and it'll probably be around the same result as this one. Hopefully I'll be allowed to get in the breakaway. I haven't been allowed in either of these two classics, so just check what result I got overall. Yeah, Daniel Martin of course takes a nice win. 38 overall, that's actually a pretty alright result. And Duarte takes 19th, so actually I wasn't I could have got top 20 if I had any energy left. So okay, the result. Actually, just before we end this video, I wanted to check how our team is doing in the Sire World Tour. I don't think we're doing that great. 13th actually, we're not the worst. Or Kreenitz and Fisabartolo, or Fasabartolo as it's called in real life, or used to be called, are so far looking to be relegated. I think most of the points of our team have actually come from my results in Trenitalia and in the Tour of Down Under. Yeah, and Demar as well, I think he got third in Milan-San Remo, so he's got some points as well. It's pretty much only me and him who have done anything good for this team at all. But yeah, that's the end of this video. If you enjoyed it, remember to leave a like, a comment if you have anything to talk about, or just want to say anything, and subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you guys next time. See ya, goodbye.